onto your heels and just reaching your hands all the way up towards the top end of your mat. And then gently drawing your body to pull up and along the ground, rolling down the shoulders and lifting the chin up. And then drawing up into a little cat stretch, rounding through the shoulders and the upper back. Taking your head and your tailbone away, and then sitting back down onto your heels. And again, let's bring the body to pull on up, rolling down the shoulders, lifting the chin. And again, drawing up into cat, pulling up through the shoulders and the back. Taking the head and tailbone away, and sitting all the way back down onto your heels. And again, let's bring the body to pull on up. And then this time, let's curl the toes, sending your hips back and your head down. Draw forwards into a plank, and then bending with your knees and sitting back to your heels. Again, let's bring the body to pull on up, rolling down the shoulders, lifting the chin, curling with your toes, a nice long stretch off into the back body. Draw forwards into a high plank, and then bending with your knees and releasing and sitting on back. Again, let's bring the body to pull on up. And as we curl the toes, lengthening back off into a downward facing dog. Draw forwards into a strong high plank, and then bending with your knees and releasing back. Again, bring the body to pull on up, curling the toes and easing the heels back and away. Draw forwards into a high plank and then bending with your knees and releasing back. And again, bring the body to pull on up, working into that curve of your lumbar spine as we push back off into a downward dog, stretching all the way along that body. Come forwards into a strong high plank, and then bending with your knees and sitting on back. One more time, bring the body to pull on up. And then as we curl the toes, remaining in that downward dog, and then let's walk it from foot to foot. So just drawing down one side of your body, and then the other. Taking in that little stretch into the lower back and all the way along the back of your legs. And just noticing your body, checking in. And as we work through your practice today, just taking it easy. Anything that you need to take a break on, you know that that's okay. Giving yourself permission just to release and let go for a second or so. Right hand to the outside of your foot, bring your left arm up and over, looking up towards your hand. And then bring that hand all the way back down, curl the toes, lift up the back knee, and raising your right arm, looking on up. And breath in, and as you breathe out, pressing away through your side body. Breathing in to come back up. And again, breathing out, pressing out into side body.
Breathing in, nodding the chin, breathing out, engaging with the core.
the chin. And as you breathe out, we lift and we squeeze onto the circle. Breathing and let go. And then again, breathing out to squeeze as we lower back down upon the floor. Breathing and lock the chin. Breathing out and squeezing the circle as you raise the upper body. Breathing and let go.
Now
work next into a little bit of glute work with your circle. Now, if you don't have a circle, again, you don't mind, you could just put your arm out to the side. Now, I'm going to start off with the hand coming closest towards you. So my palm is going to go directly on top of the handle. Okay, so I'm not curling on, I'm not holding on, but I'm going to be pressing down. The other hand is going to line up with the hand that's on the circle. And my arm is slightly open, so the armpit feels open. Then from here, I'm going to direct the opposite leg out. Now, as I lift the leg up, I'm going to press down on the circle. As you press down and lift the leg up, breathing out and breathing into release. So breathing out, press down, lift the leg, breathing into release. Looking slightly ahead and release. Again, breathing out to press, breathing in. We want to be careful not to push too hard. Okay, just wants to be gentle pressure. Breathing out to press.
Roll the shoulders.
again. You don't have to. If you ordinarily use a band around the bottom of your feet, use it. If you use a cushion behind your back, again, by all means, use it. Otherwise, if you'd like to have a little go with using the circle, I've got it in front of the body, and I'm just going to relax down the shoulders. Okay, taking a deep breath in. As you breathe out, start to roll back and just stop there at halfway. Breathing in and breathing out, engaging with your core, sitting up nice and tall. Deep breath in. As you breathe out, navel back to the spine, carefully roll back. Breathing in and breathing out and gently drawing up. So for today, halfway may well be enough. All right, deep breath in. If you feel you can go further back, lower your back down into the floor. And the circle goes in front of the chest. Breathing in. And then as you breathe out, engaging with your core, carefully drawing up, being careful not to lift the shoulders and place the circle forwards. Breathing in. Breathing out, lowering back, carefully through the back. Breathing in. And then breathing out. Imprinting your spine, peeling the body all of the way back up. Again, deep breath in. As you go back, breathing out, lowering your body down into imprint. Breathing in. As you come back up, breathing out and peeling the body slowly back on up. Good. Again, deep breath in. Breathing out, lowering your body back. Breathing in and breathing out, imprint your spine and peeling all of the way back on up. All right, one more time. Deep breath in, breathing out to lower your body back. Breathing in and breathing out, imprinting your spine and feeding the circle forwards. Okay, let's pop that circle down. Come around onto your side. I'm not going to use the circle for the next one. I'm going to be working into single leg raise. Then I'm going to work into a double leg lift. And then I'm going to work with the foot coming forwards and backwards to really work around the hip area. So if you can lengthen all the way out and along the floor there for me. Pushing away through your toes. Lifting your head up so your ear is in alignment there with your arm and your shoulder. As you raise the top leg up, let's breathe out and extend the leg. And breathe in as you lower it back down. Breathing out and join the navel to the spine as you lift. And breathing in as you lower. So as you take the leg away, really draw up the waist away from the ground. And breathing in as you lower. Breathing out to press the leg away. Breathing in as you lower. Pointing down through your toes and extending the leg away. Breathing into lows. Really open up that range of motion there. Breathing out to lift. And in as you lower. Last one. Breathing out to press. And then if you join the legs together. And as you float the legs away, breathing out. And breathing into lower. So draw the navel back to the spine as you lift, breathing in. And if your balance is okay, take away your support hand. So we want to try here to create that strength and that connection through the core breathing in forwards, breathing out, heel goes back. And again, in to come forwards, out to come back. Breathe in and out. One more set. And out. And then we can draw up into your side bend. So then pull those knees up beneath your body. Elbow in alignment with your shoulder. Open up with your chest. Keeping your gaze forwards as we breathe out, reaching up and across, breathing in as you lower. Now if we can, we want to bend up and over from the waist and really stretch that upper arm over. Now if you want to go up onto your hand, same thing, okay, line up your hand through to your foot. And again, with your arm, upper arm, send it over as far as you can. Try not to bend at the elbow. So as you go over, stretch so you get a lovely big stretch and promote the bend into your body. And lower. As you go up, breathing out, hips draw forwards, reaching it over, breathing in as you lower. And again, breathing out to lift. Breathing in as you lower. Engaging your core, pulling up. Hips draw forward, squeeze the backside. In as you lower. Two more if you can. Keeping your navel, keeping your nose front facing. And lower. One more time, big lift up.
Lovely elongation there of the muscles.
across your ear, breathing into lower. Again, breathing out, nice big stretch over, breathing into lower. So if that's enough on the forearm today, carry on. If you're going up onto a hand, take a moment, line your body up. And then when you get ready, breathing out, lift, hips draw forwards, and you're going to reach nice and long past your ear, breathing in as you lower. So as you go up, sending that arm over, stretch out of your waist, breathing into lower. That's it, nice straight arm, hips draw forwards, rainbow the body, breathing in. Okay, and you know, like I always say, I know it's tough to keep all of that alignment going on, but it will be the way to improving your form, okay, and keep the progression of your practice moving on and lower. So your gaze is always forwards, hips are always drawn up underneath you, right? So as you go over, try not to stick your bum in the air. And then as we go up, lifting, arm comes up past your ear, and you're not changing the direction of your gaze. All right, last couple, I think. Breathing out to lift and lower. One more time. And lower. All right, come around onto your back for me. And we're going to work into your 100. Keep the circle close by, because we'll do a little bit of a stretch with that afterwards. So lowering your body all the way back and down. And if you're using something to support the neck, pop that in behind your head now. And we can bring the legs up, one and then the other. Check out the neutral spine, okay, be comfortable. Then when we raise the feet, maybe we're extending a little bit further. Maybe we can come up, maybe we support the neck today, or maybe we're patting the air by your side. Breathing in for about four, and then breathing out for about six. Okay, and I invite you to shut your eyes, go inside, really focus on that lateral thoracic breathing. And as you breathe out, just envisage as if you have a little waist belt on, and that waist belt is being tightened up when you breathe out. So nice, steady, slow breath. And we're going with 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 5, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 3, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 3, 44, 45, 46, 7, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 3, 54, 55, 56, 7, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 3, 64, 65, 66, 7, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 3, 74, 75, 76, 7, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 5, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, with 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bend your knees and bring them back down. Now, if you take hold of either your band or your circle, put one foot inside your circle and start to gently ease the leg in. Now, you can keep the other knee bent if that's better for you, or you can slide that leg out straight, whichever feels like it's a better fit for you. And we want to bring the legs straight in towards us, so try not to go out to the side. Just relaxing into that hamstring stretch. If you ever get a little bit of a shaky leg, all right, just let that tension off. Take a deep breath in, and then as you breathe out, try and go into it maybe again, but sometimes the muscles can shake a little bit when we're going to stretches.
Breath in, and then breathing out, lowering that back all the way back down. Okay, roll
gently over to one side, popping back up to seated, your last posture coming up. So I'm going to do a little rotation work with the circle today. Again, if you find this hard work, by all means bring your arms across your chest. That would be fine. I'm going to put my hands on the inside of the circle. Alright, so although this is not a heavy piece of equipment, after a while your shoulders are going to tell you about it. So if you need to, just pop the circle back. So I'm going to bring the circle up so that it lines up with the top of your eyes, line up with the top of your circle. And as you rotate, breathing out and breathing in, come back to the middle. And again, breathing out. You can of course do this without a circle, or holding your ball, or holding a band. So as we turn, breathing out, breathing in. Alright, so we want to try and turn with the upper body moving as one. So try not to get carried away with your arms, because clearly your arms would go further than your torso can turn. Alright, that's the beauty of having that ball and socket joint in your shoulder. So you're breathing out as you turn, breathing in. But to affect the spine and the core strength, we just want to turn the arms as far as we're turning the torso. So breathing out to breathing in as you come back. Again, breathing out to rotate, and breathing in as you turn it back. Again, breathing out, rotate, breathing. find the fingers behind your back and draw your knuckles downwards.